Here we check the bath control of the precision cylinder meter. It's up and running. We're in the main menu. We press options, advanced, and come to the 5 tabs, choose bath, and here we are. You see, we have a pre-bath controller, we have a main bath controller, we have a main bath temperature set point, and we can dim and switch on and off the light. The pre-bath controller has the possibility to put in an offset. Normally it's running at the same temperature as the main bath and it follows the main bath. If for certain reasons you would like to have a certain offset, you can adjust it here. You can switch on and off the auto control, disable, enable it. In the normal running mode, it is enabled, of course. If you disable it, you can adjust the heater, that is a steering element, and the cooler to any value you want, and it will stay there. We can do that here. So the heating is increased now, cooling stays at the value, and if we check here in the temperature tab, you will see that the pre-bath temperature is quickly rising. So this has been a very moderate adjustment. I'll switch it back to where it was. The cooling is in fact cooling or heating. It's the adjustment of the Peltier element, and you can use it for cooling and for heating. Normally it is used for cooling. If the auto control is enabled, you can adjust the steering. And adjust it back. But you cannot, you see it always jumps back, you cannot adjust the cooler freely because the stirrer is leading and the cooler is following. The main bath control has in addition a limit for the mean temperature drift that defines valid measurements. The standard value is 10 microkelvin per second. That is according to the thermal time constant of the conductivity cell. The auto control is here. You can also disable it, enable it, just as for the pre-bath. Here it is opposite to the pre-bath. The steering jumps back if I try to adjust it, while the cooler can be adjusted in the enabled mode because the cooler is leading here and the stirrer is following. That is designed because the stirrer here is a very fast reactive component, while the Peltier element is slower. You can use the Peltier element also here for cooling or heating. I disable the auto control now and adjust this to a higher value. You will see that we quickly deviate the temperature by a couple of millik by just this small steering action. Here we are, 3 millik, already too much as a deviation for a precision conductivity measurement. The beautiful thing is that this method of heat management, of temperature management, includes no thermal mass. So if we stop the steering action, the heat input immediately stops. You see here that the mean drift is too large now, and if you are making measurements now, they would be flagged as invalid. Here we have the temperature set point. You can use it or don't use it. If you do not use it, the temperature of the main bath remains just at the temperature it is at the moment, but normally you run it at just the same temperature, and under these conditions it would be more easy for the instrument if I adjust this set point a bit higher. But I wanted to know whether the instrument is working well under these conditions, and indeed it is doing so. Here we are, the mean drift now is small enough to continue to work.